The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On a certain Sabbath, Jesus went into the synagogue and taught, and there was a man there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and the Pharisees watched him closely to see if he would cure on the Sabbath, so that they might discover a reason to accuse him. But he realized their intentions and said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up and stand before us." And he rose and stood there. Then Jesus said to them, "I ask you, is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save life rather than destroy it?" Looking around at them all, he then said to him, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was restored. But they became enraged and discussed together what they might do to Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
We continue to meditate on the theology of pain, sin, suffering, and death. So, bala naton, duna sa aton lawas ang sala or ang inclination magpakasala. Ang kamatayon, potential nga kamatayon, wala pa subong, pero ara na da. May ara na na sa inyo, may ari na sa ako ng kamatayon. Wala pagaling nagdabuot. And suffering. So hindi ka kapalagyo. Hindi ka kapalagyo sa inclination to sin. Hindi ka kapalagyo sa kamatayon. Hindi ka man kapanago sa sufferings. Butang balon, naghimo ang Diyos ang kantaya. Galing may naglibagon ang iyang story, perfect song. Galing may isa ka note nga naglibagon. Tiyano ginhimo sang Dios, wala yung gin-erase ang note, kundi halin sa libagon, ginkambyuhan niya ang iyang music. Hindi kambyo, kundi gin-improve niya, pero based sa libagon nga notes. Amo na ang technique sang Dios. Sa aton kabuhi, abi mo perfect gid, may suffering. Pero wala yaging kuha ang suffering, kundi halin sa suffering, sugpunan niya sang bago nga music. Ang technique ya, hindi ya paghaboy ang notes. Ang technique ya, Satanas, gibutang mo libagon ha. Himuan ko siya sang bago music, abi mo di ko balo. That's why ang death, which is libagon, meaning unnatural sa kabuhi nato, and suffering, becomes part of our suffering. Pero with Christ, it will be transformed into a better thing. That's why ang death with Christ is just a door to eternal life. Suffering without Christ becomes libagon. Pero suffering with Christ becomes salvific. So, muna ang technique sa Diyos. So, salamat. Kaya binamon ang death is the end of all. Kaya binamon ang suffering is just suffering nga ka pain, no? Gamiton sa Diyos para sa aton kaayuhan. Kundi perdi si Satanas. Basta ambal lang ni Jesus, do not embrace sin, but embrace death and suffering. So tatlo, sin, death, suffering. Embrace suffering. Embrace death, kung maabot, but not a sin. Avoid sin. Or ask forgiveness if you have sinned. So amoy na ang obra sang simbahan. Kamunang obra naton. So that's why mga Katoliko, bisan pa si San Lorenzo Ruiz, dali na lang kag ang iban nga mga santos nagsuffer, pero balani lang suffering nila pwede makambyuhan sang Dios. Everything works for the good of those who love God. Good things, bad things, everything will work for the good of those who believe in God, those who love God. So ang nag-transform sa imo suffering into offering to God is the love that accompanies your suffering. So ano ang ginahimo sang Dios? Wala ya gina-erase ang suffering, kay magamit siya gali. Kay kun erase niya ang suffering, kanugon. That's why gina-allow ya ang sufferings. Gina-allow ya ang death. Pero hindi ya gina-allow ang sin. Gusto ya gidkuaon ang sin. Pero gina-allow ya ang death, gina-allow ya ang suffering, tungod may maayo siya nga makuha. Tira. Basta upod lang sa iya. Basta upod lang kay Christ. To die in Christ. To die against Christ, outside Christ, ambot kundi ka makadto. But to die in Christ, matransform ya inang death mo to the resurrection. So, una, God uses problems to direct you. Sometimes God must light a fire under you, get you in under the fire under to get you moving. Problems often point us in a new direction and motivate us to change. Is God trying to get my attention? Sometimes it takes painful situation to make us change our ways. So isa ina sa mga benefit sang suffering, death, problem sa kabuhi. Kaysa may problem kita, ang effects ng problems dato natong panumdom. Pero ang purpose ng problem, wala naton napatanaw. That's why kinanglan prayerful kita, discerning kita. Agad nga kung may mga problems, effects, di okay. Party na. Pero hindi ka mag-dwell dira. Bilang Katoliko, nag-dwell. Ano ning purpose siya? Ano ni? Lord, ano ini? Din mo ako ginadirect? Anong ginatudlo mo sa akon sa sining suffering? Kagamuna yung Katoliko. Hindi nga, ay, nag-suffer naman ako. Ay, nag-ano. Kundi, Lord, okay, may suffering ako. Pero ano ning purpose? Give me your Holy Spirit. Tudloy ako. Kung ano ini? Paano mo ni gamiton? Bali ako. I will embrace my suffering with you. Okay. That's why, kung ginadirect mo ko somewhere else, bangod sining suffering, may bayaan ako, may kambyuhon ako sa akong lifestyle, may ano ako, ginadirect mo ako nga, gintagaan mo ko sinang balatian, nga muni, anong ginadirect mo sa akon? Ano, Lord? Of course, mabalaan mo na akong prayerful ka. That's why importante ang prayer life. Kay dira, mabatian mo ang direction sang Dios. Tomorrow, padayon kita nga mag-meditate kung ano pag-ina mga purposes sang suffering sa aton kabuhi. This time, it's God directing our lives. Or sometimes, re-channeling, redirecting. Father Jonick, ops, hindi na di, sobra. Okay? So kung diri ka, mabugat gid, diri ka. Redirection sa aton kabuhi. Amen. Lord Jesus, oftentimes when we have problems and difficulties, we want to get rid of them immediately. But today, you remind us that it's not necessary because we need to discern the motive of God, the purpose of God, why we have these sufferings. And that's what the meaning of being Catholics in the world. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.